You realize that you and your wife and two children can get into boating for the price of 4 one-day lift tickets. 4 tickets is $300, right? $75 a day a person. So for $300 a month, you can get an entry-level boat. Don't buy a new one, buy a used one. Don't worry about cosmetics, just worry about have the engine checked out. Make sure
Yeah.
Spend some money on an overhaul.
They don't have to spend a lot of money doing it. You don't need a big hotel, you just need to get to a little...
Just need to pay for the launching ramp.
Yeah.
A trailerable boat, you're in business.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You can charter a small boat for roughly what a pretty good motel costs a night, $100
right.
a day.
Yeah.
Most people don't realize that the legendary Warren Miller was a sailor before he was a filmmaker.
In the early 60s, I realized surfing was getting too crowded because they invented the wetsuit and they invented leashes. And I met a guy named Carter Pyle who had designed the Pacific Catamaran. I took one ride in it and bought one, number 34. And I raced those P-Cats for years, 20-some years, had a good time. Actually, as I recall it, I took Hobie for his first catamaran ride.
Did you?
And then Hobie lived in San Juan Capistrano, and he went out and bought a P-Cat, but it was too heavy to drag across the beach. So he started experimenting with a lightweight, and then he bought a Calcat. And then he went from a Calcat, he went to where he was doing, he'd make two different hulls, port and starboard.
Yeah.
He'd reach back and forth in whichever hull was the most efficient and best. Then he'd discard that one and then add another one and gradually worked it.
Oh, that's cool.
Came up with the Hobie 14 and then the 16 and the rest is history. You can stuff an awful lot of, you can put 4 kids on one of those things and put them out in the trapeze, and in a light breeze like this, you're whisking along at 10 or 12. Yeah. And it gives them a whole different adrenaline rush than just lurching along with somebody in front of them that they can never catch up with in a race. Sailing, like a lot of things, is once you learn how to tack and jibe and dock your boat without an engine, I have a poster in my house that says, when you're only limited by the horizon, that's real freedom. And man's basic instinct is his constant search for freedom. With small boat sailing particularly, where you're all by yourself or with another person, you really have freedom to go wherever you can make the wind take you. And I had a guy from New York one time on my Hobie 33, and we were charging down the channel in Marina Del Rey, and I had an upwind slip, and I had to make a right turn and another right turn and go into the slip. And of course the main got jammed bringing it down, and we went slamming into this slip going about 100 miles an hour, and all I did was backwind the main and grind it to a stop. He couldn't believe, he was from New England, he couldn't believe that you could actually sail into a slip without an engine.
Right.
And the freedom of having that capability with a sailboat, with no engine,
the feeling to be able, it's an accomplishment, you did it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
He did it just the same way that what is his name, Vancouver, was rowing boats around up here and picked up these 175 San Juan Islands and put them on a chart, 300 years ago.
Yeah.